we're going to make our first single crochet into the second chain, put it into the left leg, yarn over, pull it out, and use your finger, your middle finger and your thumb to hold it to help secure. I mean, you can hold it somewhere else that is comfortable, but I find that holding close to hook can help me secure the base so it's not moving around too much, and then you can get a good size on the loops, that the loops are actually equal size for both of them. And you do a yarn over and you slide through both of them. So that's our first single crochet. And to do our second single crochet, then we'll do it on the next stitch. So we're going for crocheting, you're always going from right to left. And that's the direction you'll be working on, unless the stitch tell you specifically to go from left to right. Otherwise, it's always assumed that you're going from right to left. So now you will look at this. This is the stitch we make. And so it opens up the loop of the V, and that make it easier for you to know where is the second stitch, which is, if you see it between my fingers, this is the next stitch we're going to work into. And the same thing, we'll insert our hook to the left leg of the chain, yarn over, slide it through the leg and hold it tight, and yarn over, slide it through both loops. And now we make two single crochet. And we'll continue to do all 36 of them. So we already make two. I need to make another 34 to finish the first row. Okay, I have a few more, but for example, if you're counting in heart and you lose your count, you do not know how many stitches you already have. And this is how you're going to count it. I usually count it from the last stitch I work. And you'll see that the top of a single crochet is also a V shape, but in a different direction. So the V that we did with chain stitch, it go in this direction. And then the single crochet stitch that we do is going this direction. It's just the way that when we are working in directions, it just naturally comes into this way. So when later on, when we flip work, then you'll see that the V shape go back into the other direction this way. So we'll count the V. It's a little bit hard to count the body if you're not familiar with it. So count the V. And here is my first stitch. So this one is our active stitch. It's not counted as one stitch. You count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Okay, here's my 32. So now I have 32 single crochet that's made. I need to make four more. So do I have enough? I have 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, I'm correct. So four more. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so now this is your first row with your chain stitches at the base to start your crochet project. And then you have your 37th chain stitch at the side to go up, a vertical to go up. And you have single crochet going from your right to left as the first row. And when you want to count the top V. This will be the same thing when you're counting stitches for all the other kind of crochet stitches. They all have a V shape at the very top. So if you want to count stitches, just count how many Vs you have. And to do your second row, we're going to flip the work. So we're going to flip. So this is our right side. and then we flip to our back side, and you'll see this is the back of single crochet. It actually look a little bit different from the front. Okay, the V is much more obvious when you're at the front. So now we change it to the wrong side. Front side, wrong side. Okay, so now because we flip, we can work from right to left again. And to begin a row, you will need to do one chain stitch, as it's the same thing for the first row to raise up the height so you can work your single crochet correctly. So we'll do one chain. So I actually bring up the height. Now I'm a little bit taller than as I'm here. So if I didn't do that chain stitch, my hook will be here. But after I do that chain stitch, my hook is here. And now we're going to insert differently from inserting into a chain stitch. We're going to insert our hook into the last single crochet we make, and you want to insert to both legs of V. So if you look from the front, you can't see both legs, but if you flip it a little bit to the front, you see that, okay, here's a V shape of your first stitch. This is the chain stitch that I make as a side, and don't count it as a stitch. And this is my active stitch. So I'm going to insert the hook into both legs. So you see that there's actually a hole, quite obvious. It's not too difficult to find it. So it's over here. And then you insert it. And you see this is how it looks like now. So here is my active stitch here. And this is the two legs of the V, which is my single crochet, like the top of the last single crochet I make. And now we're going to do a single crochet. So you do a yarn over, slide it through both legs. And now I have two loops, and do yarn over and slide it through two loops. So that's our first stitch, first single crochet of second row. And we'll do the same thing for the rest 35 stitches. So you insert it to your next stitch. So if you flip it a little bit this way, and you see the V shape beside it, insert it underneath both legs, yarn over, slide it through, yarn over, and slide through both. So that's our second single crochet. And we're going to finish the rest. So the last stitch, here is your last. And this tiny bump on the side is that 37 chain stitch. So do not work anything on that stitch. Work on the first single crochet that you made. And that will be our 36 single crochet of second row. Here, and pull it through. Since we've do two rows now, so here you see there's two rows of single crochet stitches. And it's the same thing to do the third rows and rows to continue. And we have our second homework, that is to make single crochet dishcloth. And your finished project should look like this. So since we're working back and forth, we're flipping the work back and forth constantly, the wrong side and the front side is actually the same thing. Like they actually look exactly the same because we didn't work in the round or in any other direction. We always work it back and forth from the back and then to the front. And this way, it doesn't matter which side it is. They all look the same. Some trick you can do when you're counting rows is that I put a locking stitch marker on every fourth row that I make. So I know this one is the fourth row of single crochet I'm making. And when I'm counting, I know this is the eighth row over here. And then this is the 12th row and so on. So I know how many rows I make, because if you are starting, it might be a little bit difficult for you to know which which row you're at. And since there's front and back of the stitch, so you want to, you will need to count it a little bit differently. So they look a little bit like bumpy ridges. So here, this is, for example, this row is the back row. So it look like there's two leg and then there's a top of stool, almost like a tiny stool. But if you look at the front, so this row right above is actually the right side row, and it look like a V. So this is how you count your row. Okay, for example, if this one is my beginning, let's say. So row 1, row 2, row 3, row 4, row 5, row 6, and so on. And if you count it from the bottom, and you'll see this is the right side. So you will count this. This is your right side stitch. So row 1, row 2, row 3, row 4. Look, I'm correct. Here's a row 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that's how you're going to count your rows. So now you know how to count stitches with a V shape, and then you can count your single crochet row as the way that I have demonstrated.